In this video lecture, we are going to continue our discussion of chemical messengers. Specifically, what I would like to focus on are intracellular mediated responses. And so let's go ahead and zoom in on your outline. So just to remind you where we are in your note set. And so we've been talking about signal transduction pathways. And so I've given you a brief introduction to what a signal transduction pathway is. And now what we will do is focus on the intracellular mediated response. So when we think about an intracellular mediated response, it's really important first off to realize what type of ligand we're talking about. In this case, we have a steroid hormone here that's in the blood, okay? And so we know that steroid hormones are lipophilic. So intracellular responses are for lipophilic ligands because their receptor is generally in the cytoplasm or in the nucleoplasm. And in this example, we're showing you a receptor in both locations. So these are lipophilic ligands that only exhibit intracellular responses. Think about the name. Intra means within. So these are cellular responses within the cell. And it also tells you where the receptors are located. They are within the cell. Okay, so let's start with the steroid hormone that diffuses through the plasma membrane of a target cell. So lipophilic hormones can you freely diffuse through the plasma membrane of the target cell, and then they can bind to either a cytoplasmic receptor or they can bind to a nuclear receptor. Now notice up here that we have a receptor in the plasma membrane. So there are some exceptions where you have some hormones that can bind to a receptor in the plasma membrane. Okay, so once the ligand binds to the receptor, you form a hormone receptor complex. So that occurs whether it's a cytoplasmic or a nuclear receptor. So if the ligand binds to a cytoplasmic receptor, then that is going to enter into the nucleus via the nuclear pore. And then that hormone response complex is going to bind to the DNA at a particular location on the DNA called the HR element. So then in most cases, what that is going to do is that's going to activate a gene. And we know if a gene is activated, then transcription can take place, which produces your messenger RNA, which travels out into the cytoplasm, and then translation can take place. And we know that the end result of translation is to produce a new protein. Okay, now this is an example of when we activate a gene and that produces a protein. So then you can also have a ligand that inactivates a gene. And if you inactivate a gene, then that will turn off the gene. And if it turns off the gene, then you will not make a protein. So this is an intracellular response for lipophilic ligands. And in this example, we used a steroid hormone.